Today is Monday. Today is like the 19th. I'm about to get ready for Bible study is tonight, y'all. So I'm about to do my hair. Put y'all like this right fast. Y'all got my dress. Y'all like my dress? I love my front dresses. I'm gonna put the water on my hair. Today. Just trying to go to church, that's all, you know. Trying to get some little word in. I didn't go to church yesterday, so about to go to Bible study.
People have a very good reputation and a very good sense of loving people. Like, I've only been here since December, and the love that I've received, I see the love of everybody. So just want to encourage everybody to stay in unity, because we need each other. Because I don't know about you, because I've been through a lot of bad experiences, church experiences.
Yes.
And kind of like Pastor said, sometimes church people can be rough.
Indeed. Rough. Really rough.
You say that? You're supposed to be a believer. What? You're supposed to be a brother and sister in Christ? It's challenging. I mean, but the good part about it, and the thing that we have to always remember, is that who we serve and our purpose in serving Him. The promise to us is that we won't stay in the same place. He wants us to grow. And because of that, we have to go through some of these things. Because if we didn't go through them, we never would, you know, grow. Because, you know, you get your heart break a few times and it's like, okay, that's the learning, let's move on.
Right.
You're gonna continue to go around the tree, round. Stop. Let's move on. All right. Key verses found in Ephesians 6, 12, and 13. Somebody read for me, please. For us, class. Anybody?
For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be also able to withstand in the evil day. And having done all, to stand.
What about that? Those two verses sticks out the most for you. Because a lot of times, people respond and react, and it is what it is. And they trying, the devil's trying, the enemy's trying to get at you.
Mm-hmm.
And the best way he can get at you is to use people.
Mm-hmm.
Especially those who you think is close to you, or those who say they love you.
Right.
Okay. All right, let's go over to the next page. Page 2. Scripture. All right, a whole bunch of scripture. This is good, not everybody else can read it except me. Anybody can volunteer, let's just alternate verses, read one or two, and then, you know, just let somebody else have it.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that he may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil.
For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against power, against rulers of the darkness of this world, as against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and have done all to stand. Stand therefore, having the loins girded about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness.
And your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked.
And faith the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints.
As for me, the utterance may be given unto me, that I may open my mouth boldly and make known the mystery of the gospel, which I am an ambassador in bond, that therein I may speak boldly as I ought to speak.
Paul's reminding us that it's we're in spiritual warfare, we're in a fight. But the good thing about it that we need to know is that we're on the winning side. You got all the equipment, you got all the tools, but you got to bring them to battle. You got to bring them to battle. It's just like how you use sports analogies. We used to train to wrestle, and we should train the football. Coach would give y'all the shoulder pads, the helmets, the knee pads, the girdle pads, the anklets, and the shoes. But the coach can't get on the field for you. You got to play the game. So you have been equipped with all the tools. If you notice in the passage how Paul covers every part of the body with a piece of equipment. Because the enemy is going to attack you at all sides, every place that he can. How his job is, if you're in war, his job is to get you and take you out. And he's going to try to find your weak spot.
Mm-hmm.
You can't get your head, you get your heart. You can't get your heart, you get your hip. You can't get your hip, you get your leg.
Mm-hmm.
You can't get your leg, you get your foot. That's why the scripture says put on the whole armor of God, that you might be able to stand. Because you got to stand and fight. Okay?